This easy project came about because of Alice's comment on my thread rack. And I've put a link to it just up here. Alice liked my thread rack, but she didn't have the necessary tools to make it. So she's got a jigsaw and a drill and basic woodworking tools. So she's asked me, is there a way we can do it with simpler tools? So I had a bit of a think, and this is what I've come up with, Alice. Hope you like it. I almost never throw anything out. When I dismantle something, I keep all the parts, the screws, everything off of it. So what we're after is something like that. And this will sit on the top of that. Now we'll have to extend that up, but in general, that's the general idea. Now, we want cheap, that's what we want, cheap, because they're going to be buying a few of them. And, yeah, that one will get out into the centre and be long enough. Alright. And that'll probably be about the cheapest thing you could buy. That would be really good. So we want something like that. I'm thinking of something along the lines of these. So, from the hardware store, got two packets of the wall plugs. There's 50 in each packet. I think they'll do a great job. And I've got three packets of these. There's 25 in each, so that gives us 75. I need 84 for what I'm gonna do, but I have some in my hook box over there, so we'll get there. Now, these are quite hard. I think they'll do a really good job, and they're quite a tight fit on the hook. So I'm thinking there's no need to glue them. They don't want to come off. And in theory, when you're using them, you're not trying to pull them off. This just sits on there. So I don't plan on gluing them. If they start falling off, yeah, we'll glue them up. But when you really think how often things are going on and off of them, so. If you have a hard time putting them on, bit of hot water, just the bottom edge, put it in hot water before you go to push it on, and it'll soften the plastic a little bit. So, anyway, let's get on with it. Alright, so this is the board I'm going to use. It's MDF. It's 3/4 inch thick, which means the thread won't come out the back of it. So, and that's the size. So you can get these cut to size. If you want to get them cut to size, you might just buy one straight off at the hardware store. They come in, they store them in different sizes, so you might end up with that, the right size for what you want, already cut. Alright, here's another idea, melamine. You can buy that at the hardware store, which is, that's particle board with a bit of a Laminex coating on it. Really easy to keep clean. This one here is the shelving, a shelf out of a kitchen cupboard. So an idea. We're just drilling holes, so should look good. That's melamine. We've an off cut of melamine. We've actually got our hook in right now, so it cleans up quite nicely. No one's been sliding around in the workshop a bit. But now, if you use half inch MDF, the thread on the ones I've bought will actually stick out the back. So you've got to stick to like 3/4, or you want a shorter thread. But 3/4 inch is probably the way to go. Now, in saying that, this is a whiteboard. It's got a light tin face on it. It's already got a, I don't know, 4 or 5 mil MDF in the background here. Now, if you got half inch, cut it with your jigsaw so he nicely fits in here. Stick it on your bench or kitchen table, wherever. Slot glue all over it. It'd just be a wood glue. Put this down, some bags of sugar, anything, anything heavy, just to hold it down overnight. And then you've got, this will be glued to that. Look at that, looks pretty cool. And we're just gonna drill holes in it. And with these hooks. So that would be good. This would be pretty good to clean too. So, but it's got the frame. You can pick up a picture frame. Anyway, just be creative. Look around what you've got. Sometimes they sell doors with the frame already around it and it looks pretty cool. So, and they would be ready to take your screw holes. But think outside the square. Just don't be in a rush. You'll see something you want. Right. Now, next job, I'll do the routering around my wood I'm going to use. So that's my router. We'll zoom in and I'll just show you the bit I used. Right. So it's got a bearing on the top, which will run around the bottom edge of the wood you're using. And this cutter is spinning, so that's gonna take off everything outside of that. So that gives you a general idea of the shape of the bit. So that's the pattern we've got around the top now. Looks pretty good. That'll just paint up and come up good. Quick safety note, the dust from MDF is no good for you. You don't want to be breathing it in. Wear a mask, it's worth it. Any dust, whether you're sanding, doing whatever, if there's dust, wear a mask. When you're using power tools, wear earmuffs, it's worth it. And learn to use them safely. Try to keep all your fingers for later on in life. It's worth it. I've given it a quick coat of paint, which is just wood primer. That'll make my pencil lines show up really well. And then I'll drill holes and I'll paint it with a top coat before I screw in the hooks. 60, 66. So that's our grid. So on the intersections of these are where we'll drill the holes. We just mark the depth we want to go. Let me just clean that out. Right, we'll just mark the depth we want to go. Just about there. Off and off. Yep, that'll do, mate. Bit of hot water. Let's see how this goes. Oh, yeah. Look at that. This way. We're getting there slowly. Right, this is the embroidery thread my wife uses. Got a nice big hole on the bottom and the top. There's no weight in these things. Right, so goes on. You don't sneak one in underneath, it still sneaks in. Got thread hanging everywhere. This one's just a little bit different. It's got a bit smaller, shorter. Now, if you want to put him in, he still fits there. This one, he's got a smaller hole, different shape altogether. Now, because I've built these for these, this is, you'd want to have that up a little bit higher if these are the threads you use. They'll still fit, but that fits all right. Just measure when you're putting them together that you can actually get them around the corner, or stagger them. Have one here, so you'd be putting them in between everyone separated, or just step them up just a little bit. Like that doesn't have to be up too much further to be able to get it on. But yeah, let's hang it on the wall. This is the top. Just put something on here to hang it from. Yeah. gave us our line. There. Right. There are the two mounting brackets. I've marked the distance between the two on my spirit level. So we're going to get one there to get the spirit level right. Second one of which is there. Here we are at the end of another video. All finished, hanging on the wall, working well. Very minimal tools, really just a drill to drill a hole for that hook. Hope this gives you a few ideas when you're making one for yourself. The wife will like this, I'm sure. If you like the video, please click like. And if you want to see more videos, please subscribe. Thank you for watching.